This car is a 2001 Toyota Highlander with 3.0 liter 1MZ-FE V6 engine. This car is up in the air today because it had a little problem. It's an oil pressure problem. So I have the ignition on, the engine not running. So while this car was driving down the road, the oil pressure warning light came on. Luckily, the driver of this car, as soon as he saw this light, he pulled over, stopped the engine, and called us. I suggest to you, no matter what car you're driving, unless it's an electric car, of course, if you ever see this oil pressure light come on, then do the same as this driver did and stop the car immediately. Fortunately enough, this happened very close to our shop, so we went over and we pulled the car into the shop. We checked the oil level on the dipstick and the oil level was fine. Next thing we did is just for a look-see, we pulled the front valve cover. And this is pretty easy to do on this car. And what we saw under the valve cover was pretty terrifying. It was an accumulation of sludge, and I wish that we'd taken a picture of it, but we didn't. Sludge is kind of a pasty material that accumulates in Toyota engines. For as long as I've worked on Toyotas, I've seen sludge in the engine, and sludge has even been the subject of class action lawsuits by Toyota owners against Toyota. So sludge, engine oil sludge, is a very common problem in Toyotas, and it can lead to all kinds of problems. So our next step was to pull the oil pan. We are looking up into the sump of the 1MZ-FE. This right here is the oil strainer. This is the oil pickup, I mean. It has a strainer. This is where the oil is sucked up and flows up into the oil pump. Okay, so this strainer here, which is a screen, was clogged up with sludge. So we took the pickup off. It is held by two bolts right here and a third one right here. So we took that off and we cleaned it very thoroughly. The oil pan had big chunks of sludge just sitting around, and the strainer of the oil pickup tube was plugged up with sludge. At this point, we knew we had a problem. We just didn't know how bad the problem was. This is the oil pan of the 1MZ. Before we cleaned it up, it had some little chunks of sludge just sitting in the bottom of the pan. So we cleaned the pan thoroughly. We cleaned the flange extremely thoroughly so that it can be resealed. But the main thing is we got all the sludge out. Our next step was to pull the oil pressure switch, or sender, as it's called sometimes, to check its condition. And this sender, the opening, is visibly plugged with sludge. So this could affect the oil pressure reading. Now let me show you where this is situated on the engine. The location of the oil pressure sender is nestled on the front of the engine. This means the timing belt side. And it is located behind the crankshaft pulley, and it's right above the crankshaft position sensor. And let me show you on one of the spare engines that we have sitting around. This is a 1MZ-FE, same engine that this one succumbed to the oil sludge problem. We pulled it out of a car that a customer brought in with rod knock, and we replaced it with a newer engine. So the location of the oil pressure sensor is right here, and it plugs in to this single wire harness connector. Here's a view of how we get the oil pressure sensor out. First, we reach in and we press on this tab on the harness connector, and then that releases the connector from the sensor. Okay, so 24 millimeter goes right around the sensor, and we can unfasten the sensor and get it out. So here's the course of action that we decided on for this car before we went to replace the oil pump, which is a huge job and might not be necessary, or even replace the entire engine, which is an even bigger job but might not be necessary. And what we decided to do was to clean up as much sludge as we could from under both valve covers, front and rear. Then we cleaned up all the sludge that we could from the oil pan, and then we filled it back up with oil and decided to run it and test the oil pressure, and I'm going to show you how we did that. This is an oil pressure test kit. I got it from Napa. It's Carlisle Tools brand, which is a Napa brand, I think. Let's see what's in this kit. There's this instruction sheet. There's a oil pressure gauge that comes at the end of a pretty long hose. This hose is, I don't know, it's about 4 or 5 feet long. And this kit comes with an assortment of different fittings to fit different cars. And the most important thing with this, as far as I'm concerned, is that it has some metric and British thread fitting adapters. I think one of these is a M6 thread, and this one might be, well, actually this one is the one I want to talk about, and this one is an M8 thread. They're both M6x1, M8x1. They're both metric threads, but this one is the most important one for us working on Toyotas, because it is a British standard pipe thread, and that is the thread specification for oil pressure sensors on almost all Toyotas. So let's go and have a look on how we use this pressure gauge and the fitting. So using our spare engine, our dummy engine, let's have a look at how we use the oil pressure gauge. First, we take this adapter, which is the BSPT adapter, 1/8 BSPT. We thread it into the oil pressure port, and we can use a wrench and socket to get it a little bit snug. It doesn't have to be too snug because it is a tapered thread. Next, we fit the oil pressure gauge into the fitting. So here's the end of the hose for the oil pressure gauge, and it just threads right into the fitting. And we turn it enough so, by hand, so it's snug. And again, this does not have to be all that tight because it is a tapered thread. So now our gauge is connected to the oil pressure port of the engine. And when we start the engine, we can read the pressure. So here we go, and I hope you can see this, that the fitting is in the oil pressure port. This is on the real engine, and the hose is going into the fitting. Now, if we follow this hose all the way to the end, we have our pressure gauge right here. So let's go see how this is gonna work when we start the engine. Okay, so the engine is at room temperature, and we just started it. It's showing about it showed about 75 pounds of pressure, and that's certainly adequate pressure for a start. And as it warms, the pressure is gonna go down. Now I'm just gonna cut to a later time when we see the oil pressure at operating temperature. So the oil pressure is coming down as the engine warms up, and let's just see, we'll cut to a later time. So the engine oil pressure has come down to about 25 psi, and this is where it is staying. Okay, it's not really dropping any further. Let's go see what happens if we rev up the engine a little bit. So what I think you saw, because I didn't see it, is that the oil pressure went up with the engine RPM, and then it came back down with the engine RPM as the engine RPM went down. So this is normal. It looks like we dodged a bullet with this engine. To recap, the repair we did was to clean up sludge from under both valve covers, clean up sludge from the oil pan. We took off the oil strainer and we cleaned it very thoroughly, soaked it overnight in cleaner, blew air through it and everything to clear the strainer on the oil pickup. We also replaced the oil pressure sensor with a new oil pressure sensor, and at least temporarily this is going to solve this problem, and we'll see how it goes. I'll keep you updated.